Introduction, from 3000 BC to 600 CE. In this Veli civilization, exposed many artifacts and artworks. These works give us a clear understanding of the high quality of civilization which spread over on the banks of river Indus. There is a long gap in the history of India between Indus Valley civilization and Mauryan period. The great Emperor Asoka of the Mauryan dynasty built many stupas and pillars with beautiful capitals. There are many stone sculptures which had the influence of Mesopotamian and Sumerian art. After the Mauryan, the Sunga and Kushana dynasty ruled the northern part of India many years and left some work of art and architecture. The golden period of India was the Gupta period, when all kind of art and sculpture reached the zenith. The most important contribution of Gupta are painting of Ajanta caves and few structural temples. The Ajanta paintings are considered the classical form of Indian art. Priest head. This is a beautiful piece of small sculpture which is identified as the head of a priest. The rendering of the beard and mustache and the trefoil design on the shawl are the direct influence of Mesopotamian art. Pashupati seal. This is one of the many seals discovered in the site of the Indus Valley civilization. The figure in the seal is supposed to be that of Shiva as the lord of the animals. Now children, let's know about a toy. Many different kinds of toys were made to entertain the children of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. This toy is made of terracotta and bamboo sticks. These toys make rattling sound when it is pulled by the children. Asokan pillar. Among many pillars, the Sankhesa pillar is surmounted by an elephant. The Mauryan sculptors were experts in handling animal figures. This realistic form of the elephant is remarkable. Terracotta head. The traditional terracotta artifacts continued even in the Mauryan period. The images of god and goddesses were made in this period. The mother goddess is one of the most popular forms of images, which are garishly decorated with ornaments and stylish hairdos. Standing yaksha, few larger than life-size male and female figures of red sandstone were found from Mauryan period. These are identified as the images of yaksha and yakshini. This is a very good example of very natural characteristics of Indian male figure. The pot-bellied soft torso of the male figure shows the skill of the Mauryan sculptors in handling human figure. Standing Buddha. Most probably, the first Buddha image was created by Gandhara artist. These artists were trained in Greek style. The images created by them show all the characteristics, features of Greek sculptures. The sculpture of Buddha shows heavy foldings of sanhati or wrapper in the style of Greek toga. The face of Buddha has more European features than Indian features. The most interesting part of Gandhar Buddha is the hairstyle, which has a bun on the top of the head. The stylized hair of later Buddha images is inspired by this hairstyle. Now, let's know about stupas. Stupas are built on the relics of the Buddhist saints, including that of Buddha. These hemispherical structures were built by different Indian rulers from Mauryan period to Gupta period. Though most of these stupas were demolished, but the stupas in Sanchi near Bhopal are in perfect conditions. The stupas are generally surrounded by railing called Vedika. There are four gateways on the four sides. These are known as Torana. Relief from Bharut Stupa. Only some fragments of Bharut Stupa are available now. The fragment of a Torana depicts the story of Mahakavi Jataka. The relief shows a garden which is divided with river flowing from top to bottom. A figure of a monkey is hanging from one tree of the one side of river bank to another tree on the opposite side of the river. The great monkey is Buddha in his previous birth, helping his family members are attacked by the king's soldiers. In the left side of the composition, the king is sitting in front of the Mahakavi with folded hand. Torana of Sanchi Mahastupa. The largest stupa number 1 of Sanchi is known as Mahastupa. The four beautiful toranas or gateways are decorated with relief carvings. The torana consists of two vertical square pillars in little distance and bridged by three horizontal squarish beams. These horizontal beams are again strengthened with three vertical square stone bars. The whole surface of the torana is carved with stories from Buddha's life and his previous life. The carvings are one of the treasures of Indian art. Now we have come to Gupta period, 4th century Christian era to 6th century Christian era. Ceiling painting of Ajanta. The caves of Ajanta have chaitas and viharas, which are decorated with sculptures and paintings. This is an example of ceiling painting. Indian painters always followed the typical birds and floral motifs in design. The design shows swans, lotuses, and some other small birds in the circular concentric panels of design. Mahajanak Jataka, a painting from K1 of Ajanta, 5th century of Christian era. Ajanta paintings were very much influenced by the literature of that period. The description of female beauty by the poets like Kalidas have been used by these painters. This beautiful female figure in one of the paintings of Ajanta shows flying bird-like eyebrows, fish-shaped eyes, famously called as Meenakshi, etc. The paintings are basically linear, but little use of shades has given total volume of the figure. A painting from K1 of Ajanta. The painters of Ajanta were masters in using colors. In this painting, the painter has rendered different complexion of human body. There are three shades of complexions. Fair, whitish, and dark complexions have been rendered in a masterly manner. The expressive eyes and the turns of the eyebrows are expressing all kinds of emotions or bhav that has been described in Bharatanatyam Shastra. Now, let's know about Kushana period, 1st century of Christian era to 4th century of Christian era. The sculpture of Kanishk. The mutilated, larger-than-life-size sculpture of Kanishk is standing without his head and arms. The king is adorned with royal costumes of Scythian clan of Central Asia. He is also wearing a pair of heavy leather boots and holding a long sword in one hand and a lance in the other hand. The whole sculpture is solid and of monumental quality. Kushan coins. The Kushan emperors issued different kinds of coins all over their empire. These coins are made of gold, silver, and copper. The coins have images and legends printed on them. This gold coin depicts the image of Shiva holding his trident or Trishul and leaning on his Vahan Nandi, the bull. An attempt is made to give the muscular physiques like Greek sculptures in this image. History and appreciation of art from 700 Christian era to 1200 Christian era. Dear learner, now we have come to important phase of Indian art and culture. The Gupta dynasty was replaced by the different dynasties on different part of India. The Pallavas ruled the southern part, the Hoysala in the Deccan part, Rashtrakutas in the western part, and the Cholas in the extreme southern part of India. All the kings of these dynasties were lovers of art and architecture. They built the impressive temples and Dravidian styles of architecture, which was adorned with excellent sculpture art. Rashtrakutas gave an excellent form to rock-cut temples in Ellora and Elephanta. The Cholas built large Dravidian temples and excelled in metal sculpture. The Hoysalas created very intricate and delicate form of sculpture. The central part of India was ruled by the Chandela dynasty, and their most important contribution were the Khajuraho, which are famous for its sculptures. The rulers in the eastern part of India also contributed in their own way to the development of Indian art. Particularly, the Pala and Sena dynasty in Bengal and Ganga dynasty in Orissa built beautiful temples. The terracotta temples of Bengal and world-famous Konark temple in Orissa were built during this period. Shor temple. Pallava kings were great builders. Most of the architectures and sculptures of this period are at Mahabalipuram. The structural temple was built on the seaside on the model of Dharmraj Ratha of Panchrathas, and which is famous as Shor temple. The shikhar is pyramidal in shape, which has 7 steps, reducing in size at the top. This is one of the earliest Dravidian architectural forms of South India. The descent of Ganga or the Arjuna's penance. The most imposing art form in Mahabalipuram is a huge boulder carved with hundreds of human and animal figures. The scholars are not unanimous to identify the theme of this relief sculpture. According to some, the carving tells a story of meditation of Arjuna to get weapon from Shiva, and other scholars believe it narrates the story of Bhagirath who brought down Ganga from heaven to save his ancestors. The carvings are meticulously done with every detail. The form of 2 elephants and a monkey family are surprisingly realistic. The Ananta Shayana of Vishnu, few meters from Panchratha. There are 2 rock-cut mandapas. The image of Vishnu in Ananta Shayana is carved on one of the side walls of this mandapa. The horizontal composition is balanced with the vertical figure of the Asura in the right side of the panel, while a figure of Vishnu is lying on the coil figure of Sheshnag. The snake or Sheshnag is protecting Vishnu with its 5 hoods in the left side of the composition. Rashtrakuta, 8th century to 10th century of Christian era. Kailashnath Temple of Ellora. The Kailashnath Temple of Ellora is carved out from a part of a hill. The temple is in Dravidian style of architecture and decorated with relief sculptures in the outer side of the temple, and the inside of the mandapa is also painted with murals. This temple is dedicated to Shiva. Different episodes of Shiva Puran, Ramayan and Mahabharat have been carved on its walls. Sita Haran, abduction of Sita. This is a relief sculpture on the wall of Kailashnath temple. It shows how Jatayu, the great bird, is trying to stop Ravan from taking away Sita to Lanka in his flying rath. Ravan is fighting Jatayu with a sword and a shield in his 2 hands, while Jatayu is pecking on the thigh of Ravan with his beak. It's an excellent diagonal composition on a rectangular space. Kalyan Sundar Murti at Elephanta. Beside the famous Trimurti, the Elephanta caves are carved with sculptures related to the stories of Shiva.
The iconography of marriage of Shiv and Parvati is known as Kalyan Sundar Murti. In this relief sculpture, the marriage ceremony of Shiv and Parvati is shown. The wedding is attended by God, goddesses, and other celestial persons. Dear learner, now we have come to another important dynasty, that is Chola art, 10th century to 11th century of Christian era. Brihadeshwar Temple of Tanjore. Brihadeshwar Temple is one of the tallest temples in Dravidian style of architecture. The Viman of this temple is conceived from the Dharmraj Rath of Mahabalipuram. Viman is the main temple where the image of Shiva is installed. The outside walls of this temple are decorated with sculptures. These sculptures also show some poses and postures of Bharatanatyam. In fact, this classical dance form, which was completely forgotten, was revived from the poses of these sculptures. Parvati. Chola dynasty was very famous for its bronze sculptures. Making of bronze sculptures is a traditional art form of India, which could be traced even in the Indus Valley civilization. But the most mature form of this art emerged during the Chola period. The Nataraj Murti is internationally famous, but the Parvati images of Chola are no less beautiful. This beautiful sculpture standing in Abhang Mudra, in which she has the body pressure on the right leg and the left leg is slightly touching the ground. The statue is highly finished and with perfect anatomical detail. No doubt, this sculpture is one of the brilliant creation of the Chola artist. Chola Ganesh. Ganesh is a very popular god of Hindus and worshipped all over India. This bronze sculpture of Ganesh shows the mastery of the artist, in which the fluent mass of the figure of Ganesh is formed in three dimensions. The tactile quality of the form is skillfully achieved by the modeling of the figure, in which the softness of the belly is contrasted with the hardness of the bones of the two legs. In spite of the massiveness of the form, the image of the Ganesh remains cute and lovable. Hoysala art, 11th century to 14th century of Christian era. Chennakeshava temple. The Hoysalas were ruling in the Karnataka area and built beautiful temples in Belur and Halebid. The architectural style of Hoysalas is very different from Nagar and Dravid style. It is based on a star-shaped platform with a very small shikhar. The temples were built with a kind of stone which are very soft when it is quarried and later become hard. So it allows to carve very intricate designs on the stones, almost like that of ivory carvings. Chennakeshava temple in Belur is good example of Hoysala style of architecture. Vishnu and Lakshmi. According to some art historian, Hoysala sculpture are regarded as the beginning of decadence of Indian sculpture, because the sculptures give emphasis more on over ornamentation rather than spiritual quality. This image of Vishnu and Lakshmi shows the mastery of stone carvings and in handling of very delicate designs of jewelries and costumes. The composition is overcrowded with all kinds of forms. Nevertheless, one must appreciate the craftsmanship of the sculptures. Dear learners, now we are moving from southern part to eastern part of India. Ganga dynasty in Orissa, 11th century Christian era to 15th century Christian era. Sun Temple. The world famous Sun Temple of Konark is better known as Black Pagoda. It is built in Nagar style with the Jagmohan Mandap and Natamandap. Unfortunately, the main temple is totally lost and only the Mandap and Natamandap remain. The Mandap is of pyramidal shape on a square base. The steps on the top are decorated with freestanding sculptures of Apsaras playing musical instruments. In front of the Mandap, only a part of Natamandap stands with its gorgeous carvings all over the walls of faces. Wheel of Konark Temple. The design of Konark Temple is conceived as a chariot of sun god who moves around the earth from east to west. The chariot is pulled by 7 horses. On the two sides of the temples, there were 12 pairs of wheels. The wheels are designed not only with astronomical datas, but also are symbols of Hindu philosophy. Every spike of the wheels signifies the cosmic quality of the universe. Chandela period. 10th century Christian era to 13th century Christian era, Jagdambi Temple. In the temple complex of Khajuraho, there is a Nagar style of temple called Jagdambi Temple. This temple is dedicated to Vishnu, though it is named after Parvati. The temple is on a flat platform with the Nata Mandap in one side. The outer side of the walls are embellished with sculptures, but they are not as rich as it is in Kandarya Mahadev Temple. The sculptures are of gods, goddesses and apsaras. Apsara applying kajal on her eyes. The Khajuraho temples are very famous for depiction of female figures. The apsara, a celestial nymph, is shown applying kajal on her eyes, which is a part of Shringara. The slightly inclined posture gives us a suggestion of grace. The elegant features of the body are beautifully carved, and she is holding a stick of kajal and softly putting on her eyes. The composition is supported by two fantastic animals in two sides. History and appreciation of art. From 1200 Christian era to 1800 Christian era. The development of art and architecture from 12th century to 18th century remained very insignificant due to the deadline of powerful Hindu rulers. In the meantime, Muslim rulers became powerful, but they had very little interest in sculptural art. So more emphasis was given to the art of painting in the form of illustrated manuscript. The manuscript of this period belonged to Hindu, Jains and Buddhist. The Jain miniature painting of Gujarat inspired the painters of Rajputana. The Rajput miniature paintings are classified into Rajasthani Kalam and Pahari Kalam. The Mughal emperors like Akbar, Shah Jahan and other patronized miniature painting in the style of Persian painting, known as Mughal paintings. Another kind of manuscript illustration was developed in Bengal and Bihar under the patronage of Pala dynasty. The temple architecture was developed in some areas of India, like terracotta temples in Bengal and Bihar, and marble temple at Mount Abu are the excellent example of artistic quality. Painting of Lord Mahavir from Jain miniature. Jain palm leaf painting had flourished under the patronage of Jain merchants and shipbuilders of Gujarat in 10th century onwards. The main characteristics of these paintings were masterful control of forms, well-defined sensitive line drawing with a gesture, and application of vibrant colors like gold and silver. The stylish figure of Lord Mahavir, seated on a golden throne, he has a beautiful hairstyle with very well-defined eyebrows, big eyes and long earlobes. His body is covered with a white robe with a red border. Two females winding Lord Mahavira on the both sides. Rajasthani miniature, Dholamaru, Mewar. This 17th century miniature painting depicts an instance of King Dhola and Queen Maru. The royal couple are mounted on a camel, the preferred means of transport in desert of Rajasthan. This elegant, colorful painting has full of expression on the faces and eyes of the couple. Costumes are in flat color with minute design on it. The couple are decorated with jewelries and ornaments. Even the camel is also embellished. Mughal miniature, Akbar on Elephant by Basavan and Chaturmuni. This Mughal miniature is portraying the young Akbar bringing an elephant under control. The painting shows Akbar's ability to rule and control. The Emperor Akbar sitting on an elephant which is running over a bridge made of boats. The miniature depicts something unusual happening. Every human figure is alert and attentive due to the uncontrolled elephant. The painting is full of action. Each element and action is packed with thrill and movement. Pahari miniature, Ragini Sihuti, Kangla School. In this painting, a young princess named as Ragini Sihuti, like a ringmaster of a circus, caressing two tigers standing on her both sides. The smiling faces of the tigers are being caressed by the princess. She's charging the entire ambience with soft notes of rhythmical rising pitch and gentle tones. Ragmala paintings are almost revealing such visual personality of the illustrated raga. Abduction of Sita by Raman from Panchvati. Pahari miniature, Chamba School. This painting is depicted in two different segments. In the first one, on the foreground, Ravan is shown as a saint, caught hold of Sita's hand and dragging her. In the second segment, on the background, the abduction has been depicted. Ravan captivated Sita on a flying chariot. The Jatayu is trying to stop Ravan. The painting is full of greenery and natural beauty of dense forest. The sky is blue in dark tone. Cottage hut made of straws and leaves shows the natural habitation of the forest. Three white cranes sitting at the bank of a river beside the hut. The painting has clear-cut line drawings, well-balanced coloring with full of action. A Sufi saint, Dakini miniature of Bijapur. The painting commissioned under the rule of Ibrahim Adil Shah. A saint is wearing a distinctive white turban wrapped around a red skull cap. A shawl over his shoulders, he's holding a long stick on his left hand and a holy book in his right hand seems to very embodiment of rigid orthodoxy. His face seems to be full of enlightenment. Near his feet, two partridges busy hunting food grains from the grasses. The background is flat to bring out the image of the saint in contrast. A cat eating a lobster, Kali Ghat painting. It emerged as a change in the urban society of 19th century at Calcutta. With the growing importance of Kali Ghat temple over the period of time, developed a distinct school of Indian painting in the form of traditional art of scroll painting, which was popular in the rural areas and essence of daily life. In the painting, a big cat shown holding a lobster in its mouth. Very simple line drawing border with brown and red color. A pale yellow background. The cat is in yellow and black color. Its two prominent ears are visible. The two cunning eyes are wide open. A big, fat, thick tail in black is balancing the composition. The mustaches and black line drawings are prominent. Well-defined line drawings of the lobster can clearly visible. Pattachitra of Odisha. Patta paintings are mainly done on piece of cloth using various natural colors extracted from nature. This painting has elegant floral design using leaves, flowers, and curved motifs. Each painting has different themes, color schemes, and border decoration. The figures are bejeweled in very decorative costumes using attractive bright colors. The painting shows Garud carrying Lord Vishnu on his back and Goddess Lakshmi is sitting on Lord Vishnu's lap. Below the figures, the effect of clouds has been created with round curved lines. Terracotta panel from Bishnupur, Bankura, Jor Bangla Temple. Bishnupur was ruled under Gupta period by local Hindu king Mallas, who paid tribute to Samudragupta. Bishnupur is also called Mallabhumi during the Mall rulers after 994 Christian era. The terracotta panel has been taken from Jor Bangla temple. The temple was built by King Raghunath Singh Dev II in 1655 Christian era. The panel shows a Portuguese warship is carrying soldiers with firearms. The warship, which is in the shape of a dragon head, on which 8 soldiers are standing in a well-attentive alert posture. And the sailors are sailing the ship, which is very decorative. The waves of the water have been shown in curves to show the movement of flowing water.
जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने रावों को आलोकित करने हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय के लोच से युक्त हो मित्रों हम उठे और जागे